Up in tomorrow, next week, next month, or even next year. But let me tell you the biggest thing that I fear. See, I fear that we push back the growth with our Heavenly Father because sitting down and cracking an old book is such a bother. And this will keep us from when He comes again, because our relationship with God isn't real. No, see, it's all just pretend. Now, it may be what we claim to be, yet some of us have never prayed to God in our lowest posture, on our hands and on our knees, and you may think that I'm being harsh, but I'm just being honest. Because if you truly understood what this day means, you would follow our Lord and Savior to the extreme. If you truly understood what this day meant, you would repent, you would lament, you would represent what it means to be a Christian and do everything in your power to have a one-way ticket heaven admission. Now see, the day that Jesus returns, what a glorious day that'll be. When Jesus comes from heaven to earth to set us free. And I cannot wait to leave it all behind. All of the worry, all of the fear, and all of the doubt that once filled my mind, and finally sit in the seat where my name has been assigned. But we can only approach this day with hope instead of fear. And being a Christian is more than just a title or a religion, but what we actually appear. Now I want you to experience what this day will hold, but in order to do that, your faith in God cannot be timid. No, see, it has to be bold. See, in 1 Thessalonians 4:16, it says the Lord will descend from heaven to earth, and this day won't be silent, but filled with noise. It'll come with a shout, and the trumpets will play. And when we hear these sounds, let us not be afraid, because we'll be surrounded by tens of thousands of angels, and what a sight that will be. But I don't want you to miss this, that there is a war that is waged on your spirit, that the enemy is trying to distract mankind from having a pure and holy state of mind. So my brothers and my sisters, I want you to be prepared for this war and be in seek of God every single day, wanting Him more. See, this is the day that we set our hope on, where all of our brokenness, all of our pain, and all of our sin will finally be gone. This is the day that we will rise up to meet our Lord. And when we're standing face to face with our Maker, that will be the greatest reward. This is the day that every knee shall bow and tongue confess that Jesus is our Lord and our righteousness. And to those of you that felt like you never belonged or never mattered, you will finally be in a place where love and perfection will gather. See, this is the day where Jesus takes back what was rightfully ours, and where the enemy is no match to Jesus' mighty power. But see, this day could happen at any time, and I don't want you to be left behind. So hold on to what is good and stay away from evil. Because when Jesus comes again, this will be the end.